Ponyama, our dear Mua, O Sama ya Adam dear. Me Behua, me daimu, Metia Sea, me daimu, Dre, Dre, Damini Factory.
I am the earth and water, I am the full moon. I am the first mother, the universal womb. They call me sacred lotus, wisdom of the Khan supreme. The mothership that brought the first terrestrial being. I come from distant planets, and now I have returned. I am the great goddess, come to you in human form. Mysterious by nature, I hold my magic wand. Cast my kyrie shells and read them in the dirt I stand on. My power is electric, you feel it in my gaze. I will live on when others perish in the end of days. They call it immortal, I move through space.
When I am dead, wrap the mantle of the red, the black, and the green around me. For in the new life, I shall rise up with God's grace and blessing to lead the millions of the heights and the triumph that you well know. Look for me in a world when there are storms. Look for me all around you. For with God's grace, I shall come back with countless millions of black men and women who have died in America, those who have died in the West Indies, and those who have died in Africa to aid you in the fight for liberty, freedom, and life. Any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave you. Any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave. They gave leadership to our foreparents, and that leadership made them slaves. But we have decided to find a leadership of our own to make ourselves free men. Our great scholars have inspired through the colleges, the universities, have thrown away the blessed record. Babylon did it. Assyria did it. France under Napoleon did it. Germany under Prince von Bismarck did it. England under America under George Washington did it. Africa with 400 million black people can do it. If you cannot do it, if you are not prepared to do it, then you will die. You race of cowards. You race of imbeciles, you race of good for nothing. If you cannot do what other men have done, what other nations have done, what other races have done, then you have better die. Can we do it? We can do it. We shall do it. We have prayed to God for vision and for leadership. And He has given us our universal vision. A vision that will not limit our possibilities to America. A vision that will not limit our possibilities to the West Indies. But a vision that said it must be a free and redeemed Africa. Christ the crucified, Christ the despised. We appeal to you for help, for succor, for leadership. When you endeavor to carry your burden up the heights of Calvary. When white men spurned you. When white men scorned you, when white men spat upon you, when white men pierced your side out of which blood and water gushed forth, it was a black man in the name of Simon the Syrian who took your cross and bore it up the heights of Calvary. And now that we are bearing our burden of being so heavy, we just ask that you just help us all up the heights. Oh yes, the cause is grand, the cause is glorious. Surely we shall not turn back. Oh, sail on, sail on, sail on, oh mighty ship of state, sail on. Sail on until the flag of the red, the black, and the green is perched upon the hills of Africa. Because the time has come for the black man to forget his hero worship of other races and to create and emulate heroes of his own. We must canonize our own saints, create our own martyrs, and elevate the positions of fame and honor black men and women who have made a distinct contribution to our racial history. Sojourner Truth is worthy of a place of sainthood alongside of Joan of Arc. Crispus Attucks and George William Gordon are entitled to the halo of martyrdom with no less glory than the martyrs of any other race. Toussaint Louverture's brilliancy as a soldier or a statesman outshone that of any other people, hence he's entitled to the highest place as a hero among men. Because Africa's created millions and countless millions of black men and women in war and peace, whose luster and bravery outshone that of any other people. So why not see good and perfection in ourselves? We must inspire our literature and promulgate a doctrine of our own without any apologies to the powers that be. That right is ours and God. Let sentiments and cross opinions go to the winds. We are entitled to our own opinion. And are not obligated to or bound by the opinions of others. If others laugh at you, return the laughter to them. If they mimic you, return the compliment with equal force. because they have no more right to dishonor, discredit you in manhood than you have in dealing with them. Honor them when they honor you. Disrespect and disregard them when they vilely treat you. Their arrogance is but skin deep, an assumption that has no foundation in morals or in law. They have sprung from the same family tree of obscurity as we have. Their history is as rude in its primitiveness as ours. Their ancestors were running wild in living in trees of branches like monkeys as ours. They made human sacrifices, ate the flesh of their own dead and wild meat from beasts for centuries, even as they have accused us of doing. Their cannibalism is more prolonged than ours. When we were embracing the banks of the Nile, they were still drinking blood out of the skulls of their conquered dead. After our civilization had reached the noonday of progress, they were still living in holes with bats, rats, and other insects and animals. After we had already unfathomed the mystery of the stars and reduced the heavenly constellation to minute and regular calculus, they were still backwards men living in ignorance and in blatant darkness. The world is indebted to us for the benefits of civilization. They stole our arts and sciences from Africa. Then why should we be ashamed of ourselves? Their modern improvement. To be reflected and resurrected by our generation and our posterity. Why should we be discouraged if somebody laughs at us today? Who's to tell what tomorrow will bring forth? Did they not laugh at Christ, Moses, Muhammad? Was there not a Carthage, Greece, and Rome? So we see and have changes every day. So pray, work, be steadfast, and be not dismayed. Because as the Jew is held together by his religion, the white race is by the assumption and the unwritten law of superiority, the Mongolian by the precious tie of blood, likewise the black man must unite in one grand racial hierarchy. Our union must know no clime, no nationality, but let us all hold together in every country, in every clime, making a racial empire upon which the sun shall never set. Let no voice but your own speak to you from the depths. Let no influence but your own rouse you in time of peace and time of war. Hear all, but attend only to that which concerns you. Your allegiance shall be to your God, your race, your country. Remember that the Jew in his political and economic origin is always first a Jew. The white man is first a white man under all circumstances, so you can do no less. Be black, buy black, think black, and all else will take care of itself. Let no one inoculate you with evil doctrines to suit his own conveniences. Charity begins at home, so first to thyself be true, and thou canst not then be false, for no man. Because God and nature first made us what we are, and out of our own creative genius we make ourselves what we want to be. Follow always that great law. Let God and the sky be our limit and eternity our measurement. There is no height to which you cannot climb without the active intelligence of your own mind. Mind creates, and as much as we desire in nature, we can have through the creation of our own mind. And today, being scientifically the weaker race, you shall treat others only as they treat you. But in your homes and everywhere possible, you must teach the higher development of science to your children. And make sure that we have a race of scientists par excellence. For in religion and science lies our only hope to withstand the evil designs of modern materialism. Never forget your God. Remember that we live, work, and pray for a binding racial hierarchy whose only natural, spiritual, and political limits shall be God and Africa at home and abroad. With God's dearest blessings, I leave you for a while. One love.
Brothers and sisters, Marcus, Mosiah, Harvey.